What's going on, Pokemon trainers? This is Trainer Connor, and you're about to watch another Pokemon battle video. Enjoy! Okay, so we're going to be doing OU today, and I have a new team here, focusing solely on Dragonite because of the last video. If you haven't seen that, go check it out. But I did mention I wanted to use Dragonite in the next video, so you'll hear me say that again in the analysis. But it's very important that I use the Pokemon that I use in the video. I didn't really use Dragonite all too well, so that's very unfortunate. But let's jump right into the team preview. I'm excited for this. So the first Pokemon in the squad is Dragonite, holding the Lumberry. Now, if you guys haven't seen the last video, I mentioned that I wanted to use a Dragonite since I used Dragonite in the last episode and he couldn't really do anything. And so I thought I could use Dragonite in this episode to reveal its full potential as a Pokemon in the OU tier. Dragonite is holding the Lumberry to get rid of the confusion that is triggered when using Outrage over and over. We have a Dragon Dance Dragonite today. Dragon Dance, Outrage, Earthquake, and Iron Head hits extremely hard after plus one, and it's an adamant nature as well. You can pretty much sweep your opponent this way, and that is what we're going to do with Dragonite. We're going to sweep my opponent. We'll see how we do with that. Okay, so next up is Heatran. Heatran is a little weird. I will go ahead and explain what the EV spread is all about. But this Heatran is holding the leftovers. His ability is Flash Fire, and the EV spread is 232 HP, 4 in defense, 108 in special attack, and 164 speed. The idea behind this is I want Heatran to be bulky and powerful at the same time. And then we can outspeed certain Pokemon this way with the 164 speed EVs I put into it. This is a modest nature on this Heatran, with the IVs set for 0 attack, as you see there, and then Magma Storm, Flash Cannon, Earth Power, and Toxic. So the EVs on Heatran 108 will make sure that Magma Storm, Flash Cannon, and Earth Power do some damage. I'm super excited to use Heatran. We don't know how this is going to work out, but I'm positive that this Heatran will fare very well in this matchup. Okay, so I'll be real here. Gastrodon is the next Pokemon here, and I'm kind of disappointed because I thought Gastrodon could get Stealth Rock. Apparently, it cannot learn it. I feel like it can learn it. It should. But that's not going to stop me from using Gastrodon. This one is a more defensive variant with Storm Drain, holding leftovers, max HP, max defense, the bold nature. IVs are set for 0 attack, and we have Scald so we can burn Pokemon. Ice Beam to hit the flying types, Recover, and Clear Smog. Clear Smog can get rid of the stat raises of Pokemon on the opposite field. To make up for the lack of Stealth Rock on my Pokemon team, I decided to make Landorus Therian, the Stealth Rocker, for the team. Now, this Landorus is supposed to be bulky, but I want him to be very powerful as well, so we put the Flying DMZ to use Supersonic Sky Strike. The idea behind this is to use Stealth Rocks first, and then we can go ahead and KO something right after. Fly, Stealth Rock, U-turn, and Explosion. You're asking yourself, why are you using Explosion with Landorus? I've seen a lot of competitive players use Landorus, and they use Explosion to one-hit KO something. This way they can bring in something fresh, because that Pokemon will be KO'd. You can bring in something for free. I think this will work out fine. And of course, Impedimate is to lower the physical attacker's stats when they switch in, which is pretty nice. Ah, Ferrothorn, another Pokemon that I've used before, so you guys should be familiar with it. I used it in the last video, I believe. But if not, then I apologize. But Ferrothorn is very common in OU because of its ability to use Iron Barbs and the Rocky Helmet. so that physical attackers like Scizor, or to a lesser extent, other physical attackers I just can't name on top of my head right now, they can take recoil damage and I'd be happy about it. Impugnature on this bad boy. We have Spikes and Thunder Wave. Now the idea behind this is to set up Stealth Rocks with Landorus, and then you get up Spikes as well. It's a really good combination, getting all those layers out there, and then they take damage coming in. Thunder Wave could cripple fast Pokemon, Leech Seed to get recovery, and Gyro Ball could do a ton of damage, and that's why the IVs are set for zero. It's gonna do a ton of damage. I'm super excited to use Ferrothorn. Okay, so with Alakazam here, I made a few mistakes. I will go ahead and change them before the match begins, but this Alakazam should not be holding the Flying EMZ because we already have the Flying EMZ on Landorus. So I will change the item to Life Orb. And then the ability is wrong as well. I don't know what happened there. I kinda either Showdown is broken or what, but it should be Magic Guard on Alakazam, but that's okay. Don't worry about it. I'll make the changes. I'll show you guys the changes right before the battle. The EVs are pretty standard. Max Special Attack and Max Speed. The IVs are Zero Attack. Timid Nature can be very fast. We have Psychic, Energy Ball, Shadow Ball, and Focus Blast. A very powerful Alakazam that we have here. I'm really, really excited to use them. Let's do this. Again, I'll change the item and the ability for Alakazam before the match. That we did the analysis, let's jump right into the battle. I'll see you guys there. Oh, where's the Pokemon at? Oh, here we go. We got ourselves a game against Spracken Heat. And she's got a good team. Or she's got a good team. She's got Gardevoir, Zoroark, Tyranitar, Tornadusyrian, Toxapex, and Mamoswine. The main threat is supposed to be Mamoswine. And I believe that the Zoroark could be Choice Scarf the way it looks. We'll see how we do. I'm going to start out with Gastrodon. It works very well against my opponent's team, not going to lie. So I immediately go with the Scald as my opponent goes for the U-turn, brings in Tyranitar directly on a Scald. Nevertheless, I thought that was odd. And now my opponent switches out, goes into Gardevoir as I make a double. I go into Landorus. Now with Landorus in here, I was initially supposed to intimidate the Tyranitar, but I couldn't do that since he doubled. I figured I could get up my Stealth Rocks as my opponent brings in Tornadusyrian, expecting him to use Knock Off or something like that. I go into Ferrothorn, so he can take Iron Barbs and Rocky Helmet damage. Unfortunately, he goes for Defog, and even more unfortunately, he goes for the Heat Wave. I wasn't sure what I wanted to do at that point, so I decided to use Leech Seed over Spikes, which could have been crucial if I got Spikes. I figured I could go into Heatran if he's going to keep on using Heat Wave, then get my HP back a little bit there with the Leech Seed still active. He goes into Toxapex as he goes for U-turn. Doesn't do anything. I wanted to poison something with Heatran. That's not the case. So, I'm going to go into Landorus again. The intimidate doesn't matter. Well, for the knockoff, okay, I'll take that. But I really want to get my Stealth Ox since Defog got rid of them. Unfortunately, we get toxic by the Toxapex. That is to be expected. I'm going to go with the U-turn to get out of there. Go into Alakazam for the better typing matchup. We'll use Dragonite later, because I might use him if Alakazam can't take care of Toxapex. With Dragonite at plus one, it can pretty much sweep my opponent's team if I do it correctly. I go with Psychic as he brings in Tyranitar. I wanted to keep him honest right there. That's okay, because I have Focus Blast, super effective, quad effective actually as well. The critical hit didn't matter. I was Zoroark in here. I wasn't sure if it was Scarfed or Specs, so I go with the Landorus play. He goes for Volt Switch, and that means that he's probably Choice Scarf, because he would have outsped my Alakazam and what have you. He brings back in Toxapex, a Pokemon that is pretty bulky. I can't really do much to it, except for setting up with Dragon Dances or something like that. We'll figure it out, but I figured I could go with the Dragon Dance here, because I think he's going to use Knock Off or Toxic, which I had the Lumberry for the Toxic. not going to matter. But he goes with knockoff first, and then he's going to go with the classic. That is a great play by my opponent. That means I'm on a timer. And plus, you know, Mammoth Swine can come in for free. But as long as I can KO something, that will be just fine. It is unfortunate that I don't have extreme speed to out-prioritize the Ice Shard coming my way. This is where I should have switched out, because, I mean, the Ice Shard was pretty obvious. I could have just switched out into Gastrodon for that play. I go into Landorus after the fact, and I go into Heatran. A minus one Mamoswine should not KO the Heatran. However, this Earthquake just demolishes the Heatran. I was pretty sad about that, because it's a minus one Mamoswine. Are you kidding me? So I go back into Landorus, now he's at minus two, so he shouldn't really KO anything. So I'm gonna go with the Z-Power play, Supersonic Sky Strike, completely destroys the Tornadus Therian. Pretty awesome, pretty satisfying Lando for the win. Unfortunately, again, Mamoswine is back, and he has the Ice Shard. Again, I should have switched out into Gastrodon. Man, that's unfortunate. I should have done that. But that's okay, we do have Gastrodon here now, and I go with the Scald. I do get the burn off the Gardevoir, but he does have the Synchronize ability, which I changed that from Alakazam. And, well, it doesn't really matter, but anyway, speaking of Alakazam, we're going to use Alakazam. So we do have Shadow Ball, I should be faster than the Gardevoir. I wasn't expecting Energy Ball right there, but I'm happy I switched out, so. Because Gastrodon would be very critical for the Mamoswine and the Zeraora. I don't believe Zeraora would be able to outspeed, or it will outspeed me, but it won't really KO me. Sorry about that. Expecting him to Ice Shard, I finally make the right play, going to Ferrothorn to dodge it. However, he does have Earthquake. But we do have Life Orb Recoil on the Mamoswine, so it's better to have that than nothing, I suppose. Here he goes with the Icicle Crash, and he flinches me. This is really, really unfortunate, because what you're gonna see is, had I not gotten flinched here, I was gonna go with the Recover. I can't use Recover, because I got flinched again. What is this? He flinches me twice, I was gonna use Recover, that way I could live in Outrage from this Zeraora, because I'm pretty sure it's Choice Scarf. Oh man, that is definitely bad news bears. And the fact that he's Choice Scarf is right here, because look, I live outspite him, okay? I live outspite him. So we lose this game all because of the flinches, but it was a close game. I probably should have just switched out more often than I should have in this game. I realized because of the Ice Shard and the Icicle Crashes, and of course the Choice Scarf Zeraora, I should have played a little bit better than that. But anyway, so thank you guys for coming to this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Make sure you give me a like and subscribe for more videos coming your way very soon. Have yourselves a wonderful day. I'll talk to you later.